All right, Christina, we thank you there. For someone known as a king of voiceovers, he sure has a lot of on-camera work to talk about. From Louisiana, no less, it's the three-time Emmy winner. Here comes Keith David. Keith, nice to see you, sir. How are you?
I'm excellent and looking to do better.
All right, fair, aren't we all? How toasty and humid is it in Louisiana?
This morning seems to be a pretty nice day. I mean, I haven't been outside yet. Been inside doing my yoga and trying to keep safely distanced.
Fair enough. Are you at work on production now? Because that looks almost hotel roomish to me.
It is a hotel room, and I am working. I'm under strict protocol right now, so we're. I was tested yesterday. I will be tested again tomorrow, and before I start working on Monday.
And let me ask you, is it Greenleaf or something else that you're shooting down there?
I'm shooting something else. I'm shooting a new horror movie.
Ooh. But you know
what? I get to play Dracula.
Wow, that's fun. Let me ask you this, because it's very interesting to catch somebody in the midst of a production that's about to begin. You've been on countless sets all over the world. The criteria you're going through right now, is it livable? Is it enough to enable you to do the production comfortably?
Well, I haven't been on set yet. So I know that they're doing everything that they possibly can to keep us all as safe as possible. The crew is also being tested on a daily basis. You know, especially the crew that's closest to the actors and in the inner circle of immediate shooting. So I feel pretty secure that they're taking every precaution, and I'm taking every precaution. The saddest part is, you know, you asked me about going out. I mean, I'm not going out because people in general tend not to do their safe distancing. I mean, people just, you know, they open things up and people start walking all over each other like it was normal times. And it's not. And that's what causes spikes, in my opinion.
I tell you what, I think that is an opinion that is widely shared. Let's talk about Greenleaf. New episodes we're going to have a chance to devour. We've talked about it over the years. I think you enjoy this because it's something you can really sink your teeth into.
Absolutely.
Do you know about the new plot line? We're going to look at a clip. Let's watch this and talk about it on the other side. Take a look.
I lost my way. And you paid the price. And my family paid the price. And I'm so, so sorry. I'm so sorry I let you be dragged into captivity by this monster.
Gee, that's a good scene. You tell me, when you finish a scene like that, how do you feel?
Mostly kind of exhausted. You know, it's, you know, I mean, it's a lot because, you know, I feel quite close to the bishop, because we've all had that moment in life when we've lost our way and, you know, praise God we get an opportunity to come back and to make amends. And that's the season he's in his life right now.
I think that's an interesting character to play. Let's talk about this. You've got these melodious, wonderful pipes. You're a fan of the jazz legend Joe Williams. When normal times return, how do you plan to honor him?
I'm working on a show called Here's to Life. And it's a journey through Joe's life.
And something you'd be performing live on stages?
When stages open up, you know, that's the goal. We don't, you know, obviously we can't predict exactly when that's going to happen. All I can say is when stages open up, I'll be prepared to do that.
Fair enough. Keith David, back to work. We appreciate the chance to talk to you today. We will tell you this, that Greenleaf is Tuesday nights. It's the fifth and final season on OWN.